Keith Richards from the Rolling Stones once said, "Good music comes out of people playing together, knowing what they want to do, and going for it." And I am so excited that these three musicians are playing together and going for it. Drummer Daru Jones, guitarist Marcus Machado, and bassist Doug Wimbish are joining musical forces to create DMD. Now, you may have heard about each of these musicians separately. Daru has played for a range of artists from Jack White to Nas to Slum Village. Marcus has strummed his guitar for groups like The Family Stand to Dutch soul singer Boris. And who doesn't know Doug Wimbish from the legendary group Living Color? But now they've come together to bring us their collaboration. I'm your host, Jodine Dorsey, and stay right here to experience this musical journey for yourself with DMD on B-Side. Introduce yourselves, and of course, obviously, what instrument you're playing.
Daru Jones, drums.
Okay. Marcus Machado, guitar.
Doug Wimbish, bass and ambiance.
I love it. Tell me, how did you guys get started? How did you guys come together to form DMD? How did that happen?
Wow.
What's the backstory here?
You started.
You started.
The first D's.
The first D.
Okay. D's in stereo here. Yeah, so.
Thank you. Thank you guys for coming. Appreciate it. Give yourselves a hand.
Yeah.
Also, shout out to BRIC TV, Jodine, Roe, yeah. Doug, Marcus, yeah. Everybody. Basically, we started. Me and Doug met in 2013 in San Francisco. We were doing, we met for the first time, and we played in like minutes. But anyway, it's a company called Mono Creators. They used to be called Mono Cases. They make these bags. I don't know if somebody have one here. But anyway, they wanted to do like a reality shoot where musicians team up for the first time and meet. So a couple phone calls happened, and anyway, I was summons to meet Doug Wimbish for the first time, and basically they wanted to capture it on film. So basically we get out to San Francisco. I'm in a room, you know, with another project that I was working on, and Doug Wimbish right out of the car. They filmed him walking into the headquarters of Mono Creators. Mm-hmm. They filmed him walking up. We introduce ourselves, and then we started jamming.
Just like that.
So that started our relationship, 2013.
Wow.
Me and Doug, you know, Doug does event called Wimbash, where he's like an all-star band where he picks like the best of the best, and they perform, you know, internationally. And he called me to, you know, after building a relationship from that, he called me to get on some of those. And then one time that I was coming down to Hartford, Connecticut, to do the Wimbash, and we just like, let's do some recording. You know, Doug was like, let's go to the studio. We would set up and do some recording. So me and Doug, we you know, first of all, I took a train from New York to Hartford, and it was a late night. Anyway, I missed my stop, and I ended up like almost an hour out of the way going to Hartford.
You ended up in Bangladesh.
Yeah, so
we got you.
I'm gonna try to shorten the story down. Anyway, so finally got to Hartford to the studio. Me and Doug, he plugged him, he wired everything up. We just recorded just some drums and bass. We didn't know what was gonna happen with it.
Drum and bass, okay.
Drum and bass. And Doug just sent me the recordings of it.
Wow.
And you know, I'm more than just a drummer. I'm also a composer and a producer. Uh-huh. And I went into my laboratory and I was like, man, there's some good stuff in here. So I just, you know, started mixing and slicing.
So where did Marcus come in?
Like, that's coming.
Oh, that's coming.
So basically,
this is the best part. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So say the best.
So basically, I ended up making some tracks out of what we did in the studio, just sketches, made some tracks. Mm-hmm. And a good friend of ours, DJ Spinner. Mm-hmm. Anybody know DJ Spinner?
Yeah.
Good friend of ours.
Yeah.
DJ Spinner, he's a friend of ours, he's a tastemaker. Uh-huh. And DJ Spinner called me excited. He was like, yo, have you heard of this cat named Marcus Machado? I was like, just Marcus Machado. I was just like Spanish cat. But anyway, he was like, yo. He was really excited. He was like, yo, I want to put you to Marcus. Like, he was raving about Marcus. He was like, man, you guys got to do something together. He was like, I get amped up when my friends co-sign somebody. Mm-hmm. So I was like, yeah. He was like, I got him here right now. And he put Marcus on the phone. Yeah. We got on the phone. We spoke. And then it just so happened that I was doing a drum clinic at Guitar Center. Went to the Guitar Center. Mm-hmm. Marcus just so happened to be out there, and I met him for the first time. He was like, we're going to work together.
Yeah.
We didn't even know that we had already crossed paths, but anyway, we finally met. And then, you can take it.
Yeah. So, bring it back. I was in the studio with Spinner. I was working on my EP that's out now called 29. So there's a song there called New Things. Me and Spinner, we did it together. Mm-hmm. And same with Daru was saying. He called me up. And, you know, Spinner was telling me, like, man, like, how you gonna have, like, your live band? Like, who are you gonna get some of the guys? And I said, man, I'm a big fan of Daru. I said, that's, like, one of my favorite drum players. He's like, I know Daru. Let me call him up. So, sure enough, we talked. And then we met up at Guitar Center. And then the first project that we did, he said, man, you know Doug Wimbush? I said, of course. And I know Doug and Living Color from the Family Stand, because I used to play with the Family Stand. Mm-hmm. And, you know, Vernon Reed, he knows me since I was like 14. So I was like, man, that's family. He goes, man, me and Doug is doing this project. You know, here's just some jams, just record some stuff. And that was like the first project that we did. So he sent me it and I just added some guitars. Nice. And I was like, man,
nice.
It was just
Nice.
And the rest was history.
Nice. You know?
But what's crazy is, is not to cut you off, is to actually, like, we actually played together with Jamie Lidell. We did tons of other stuff, but to come back, this was like the foundation. This was like the first, very beginning of everything, you know what I mean? So that's the story. DMD.
Nice, nice. So talking about jams.
Did you want Doug to finish?
Doing a great job.
Yeah, they did a great, I think so. Let's get some music in. Let's jam it out a little bit. So tell us about the next two songs you're about to play, Daru.
So we're gonna play, the first thing that we played was from Jay Dilla. Any Dilla here?
Dilla.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Dilla dog.
Rest in peace.
Rest in peace.
He died, he passed away this month. And anyway, we played we called it Dilla Medley. So it's basically an excerpt of some of our favorite tracks that he produced. Mm-hmm. And it's on our beat tape.
Yep.
D Stubbs.
M Drix.
Can we tell that story or we want to keep it moving?
We want to hear some jams.
So basically that first the first thing we played was called a Dilla Medley. And this one we're about to play is another one from the B tape. Mm-hmm. It's online. You can get it. Roots of Records, RUSIC Records.com.
And we have CDs available right now.
We got CDs available.
Of course. Get your signed copies and all that. Yeah.
And it's on internet too. You can get it. You can download it on Bandcamp.
Okay.
For free. So we're gonna play. We covered basically the beat tape. We covered some of our favorite, you know, producers, and we show love to. And it was also we banded a lot of genres. We tried to focus on hip hop, and then we moved to rock and roll, and we did some funk stuff. Right. And we covered a couple tracks from D'Angelo's latest record.
Yeah, Black Messiah.
Okay. So why don't you? Can you play the two songs real quick for us, and then we'll talk a little bit about it after you play.
Yes.
All right.
Next song.
I
need a moment.
Uh-oh.
You want to talk about that? Yeah, basically, like what Daru was saying, the B tape is pretty much just some of our favorite, you know, musicians, D'Angelo, there's a little bit of Jimi Hendrix, Dilla. One of my favorite tunes off of Black Messiah is, Back to the Future. Mm-hmm. You know, I love that. It's kind of like laid back, but you know, it's a real easy vibe. So we're gonna get into that. And yeah, let's check it out.
Nice, y'all.
Thank you.
Fantastic. So, Doug, I'm going to ask you, since you didn't contribute to the earlier story.
I'll be in spirit.
So what can we expect from this album? Is it all instrumentation or any guest vocalists? What can we expect?
Well, this is the beginning. Mm-hmm. You know, this is the beginning of our new chapter. And the sky's the limit, really. You know, we're a trio. Everybody's engaged in different vibes. Mm-hmm. So we try to bring all of those things to the center and keep a very free, open policy, you know, of what's going on. That way, that way the groove is always good. You know, if I feel a little low one day, he's got it.
Right.
I ain't worried about Daru. I know my nephew over here has got it as well. You know what I'm saying? Right. So, but the reality of it is we expect fun and expect things to happen in real time. You know, and the spirit of what we've done, the way this whole record, this project came about, came from a real honest space. Mm. You know, and when you have, to me, music is a reflection of how you live. You know, it comes out in your music.
Right.
So we've been blessed to be able to meet at this place in time to be able to just, you know, share notes, share stories through our music.
Right.
So, again, we're not the architects. We're the recipients. We're all doing this together.
Nice.
And that's really what it's all about.
Nice. So what was it when you when you met Daru? What was it? Is it technique? Is it spirit? Is it energy? What is it that you look for in musicians, being that you've been in the game for so long?
Well, you know, I'm learning every day. You know what I mean? And I think that it's everything you just said and more is what it is. Me and Daru just naturally hit it off. It's one of those things where it's like he told you how we met. And from that point, the energy was right out of the box. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? There was no other frequencies going on. So we all come from situations where, you know, you have to find your spacing when you work with different groups and everything. Right. But this is free. This is a free zone. So we found a way to just communicate right out the gate. That's my brother right there. I got to give him some splaw on that. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But in real time, that's how it all came to be. Just a natural, organic. And I'm not trying to wave no flag. I'm just happy to be here right now with y'all and to also be able to share, you know, to be able to have the opportunity to speak in a language that everybody here can easily understand. And that's just real, you know what I mean? So I'm blessed. I feel good at this stage of my career. Every day is a learning experience, and I'm being honest, you know, play with a lot of folks. Did a lot of things, very happy about the things that I've done.
Absolutely.
But I'm really happy about what happens right now in the present. I don't like to talk about the past too much. I will just now for y'all, all right? We can talk about that. But at the end of the day, what we learned from our elders, and we all had inspiration as we were able to walk, you know what I mean? And move forward and find the lane, find the different ways to be comfortable, and then you find people that you can communicate with.
Right.
And if you can have that kind of frequency, I'm paid in full.
Tell me about it.
Paid in full.
Tell me about it. So Daru, you're in Nashville now, right? Or you're traveling back and forth or what have you. What, you used to live in Brooklyn for how long?
For a minute.
For a minute, right? We're not gonna age you, don't worry about it. What was it, or was there something in Brooklyn that you couldn't get from any other city? Is there something? Tell me about that.
Yeah, it's a lot of energy. A lot of people, they're making it happen. It's always inspiration. And it's just like a lot of my friends, they work in the music business. So it's like, man, I'm about to go play with Stevie Wonder. So I'm like, man, I want to do that too. Right. So it's a lot of that. I'm inspired by my friends like Marcus, and Doug, Sugarhill Gang. Like, do your Googles.
Right,
but
right,
like,
right.
A lot of my friends here, they're doing big stuff. So it's inspiring. And that's one thing that I like about Brooklyn, for sure.
Okay. Well, you know, you can always come back home. We ain't gonna say nothing, though. Marcus, set us up for the next song. What are we about to hear now?
Yeah, you're about to hear the first single, actually, off of DMD project. It's called After Dark. So, yeah, this is for the first time, y'all. So
okay.
Keep fingers crossed.
And when's the single gonna drop?
Friday.
Okay.
This Friday. So check it out.
Yeah. Okay.
Gotta see if I remember this beat.
Oh my gosh.
Are you gonna count us?
No.
We break it. Thank you.
Played that song together.
Wow.
Ever. Matter of fact, everything we're doing is going to be the first time we play
this. This is the first here. Love that. So Marcus, one thing people don't know about you is that you've been playing since 2 years old.
Yeah.
2 years old. Yeah. So people consider you a child prodigy. At 2 years old, I don't even want to get to hard foods yet. I'm like, I think I'm still drinking out of a bottle. What was it about the guitar when you touched it and you said, I'm going to be a rock star and this is what I'm going to do for the rest of my life?
I don't know. I think you can talk to my mom right there. Stand right there.
Mama's in the house.
Well, I can speak for my mom. She said basically when she was pregnant, anytime there was music or something around, I would always would kick her stomach. So pretty much I've been playing out the womb, you know, pretty much.
Wow.
I mean, as far as I can remember, rest in peace to Al Jarreau. Mm-hmm. But actually, he was, as far as I can remember, this was like 87. I'm born in 84. And I remember my first concert my mom took me to was Al Jarreau and Chaka Khan.
Wow.
And I remember just that experience in New York. It was on somewhere, it was in Spring Valley, I remember. And it was on like a hill or something. But I just remember the music, the lights and everything. As far as the guitar, that was just around the house, you know what I mean? And everything from Hendrix to Coltrane. So, you know, pretty much I just grew up. I guess it's in me, you know, pretty much.
It's in you. And Daru, you come from a musical family. Like everybody plays music in your family.
Pretty much.
So you become a musician, and then you go into production as a producer. Was that a challenge, or is it easy to go from musician to also having a lab, or was that a little bit challenging?
Excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
Water.
Breathe out.
Anybody have some water? What was the last part of the question?
Was it challenging from going from playing being a musician mm-hmm. to actually producing and remixing and doing what you do?
Okay, so. My mom and dad, they're both musicians. Mm-hmm. They both play piano and organ. I started in church.
One time.
Yeah, my roots, you know, I learned how to play by ear. Mm-hmm. But at the time being, I'm going to tell a short story. But the church that I came up in, everything outside of gospel was secular music, and it was a no-no.
Mm-hmm.
So, of course, when I go to school, all my friends are into hip-hop. And I'm like, man, I want to know what hip-hop is.
Right.
At that time, fast forward, I was really impressed with the production. Because at that time, a lot of hip-hop that was coming out, the content may have been a little nervous. Some of the things they talked about was, you know, not parent-friendly, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But anyway, I was fascinated. I found my way to still appreciate the hip-hop, the production. So I was, you know, fascinated by, you know, Dr. Dre, DJ Premier, mm-hmm. P-Rock, so on and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
And it really helped my drumming because it just... As a musician, it's 1,000 things that you can play, but only a couple is going to work.
Right. Mm.
You know, a couple things are going to make the song pop off. Like when you listen to your favorite hit records, it's not super fancy, but it's certain things that make that record.
Mm-hmm.
So that helped me as a drummer be more conscious of what I did.
Right.
Because you know, it's all about being a team player. I'm not trying to overplay Marcus or Doug. We're having a conversation.
Conversation, right. Yep.
So yeah. It's like. A lot of times musicians, we get it twisted. We think it's all about us and we want to showboat. You know what I'm saying? Nah, it's all about making the next person sound good.
Mm-hmm.
So being a producer helped me with my thinking on what type of fields to do to complement what he's doing And yeah, I feel like that's why I may have gotten a couple more jobs.
Nice. So, Doug, I gotta ask you, because I'm not gonna age you. Don't worry, I'm not calling out any
years old. You can age me all you want. Wait for two ages, alive and dead. Everything else
in the middle, you gotta enjoy it. You better, wait a minute. You better speak a sermon right now. You better say that again.
Let's get that clear. All right, go ahead, sweetie.
So, in your career, what words of advice would you give to Marcus and Daru about being sustainable as an artist and a musician here in this music industry? What words would you share with them?
I mean, you know, like, I think they already got it. I don't really have, I mean, we're here because we subliminally share this frequency, you know what I mean? But it, just to express it for people right now, the key obviously is listening. You know, you have to find your lane, and sometimes you have to know how to be on the front burner and burn, and also sit on the back burner and simmer as well and be comfortable. And not everybody could do that. So, you know, I guess that comes from just experience playing with people. You play with your alpha males, your alpha females, you figure out how to deal with that. You play with all the different, you know, over time, every gig you do, every song you learn, it's a lesson, mm-hmm. right? Every song, every frequency, everything, you know? So for me, my lessons came from my elders that I was blessed to be around. I was fortunate to work with older folks that kind of take me under their wings. So, you know, and really what inspired, I'll give you a little short story. The reason why I'm here today is because, you know, how I wanted to, what flipped the switch for me mm-hmm. was my family's from Bahamas, not from the Bahamas, and I say you look like my Aunt Dawn.
Right.
And I used to go to the Bahamas, I'll make it short. I used to go to Bahamas when I was a kid. And when I went there in 1969, 1970, the Jackson 5, it came out. Mm. So in Nassau, Bahamas, there's no radio, there's no TV station, nothing like that. So I have young uncles. My uncles came up with the bright idea mm-hmm. to tell people I was Jermaine Jackson in the Jackson 5. All right? So this is the best part about it is, the best part about it is people over there believed it. So they would take me to a club and just say, yo, don't say nothing. You just, I had a big afro, bigger than Questlove, big giant afro picking there and jamming. So I had a big afro mustache when I was young, and my uncles just used to want to crash parties. That's what they did. So they said, listen, never mind, you just sit there and be cool. All right, we'll take care of everything. So they would roll me up to the club.
I know that's right.
Man, we got Jermaine Jackson right here, the Jackson 5. For real? They'd usher me in. You can see where people have been having a good time for hours, drinks all over the place, move them out the way, sit down. My uncles would be like, Guinness stout, please. You know what I mean? But what that did, the short end, the backside of that story is this. What I did was, after I came home from that summer, mm-hmm. I said, now, do I want to impersonate a fraud, or do I want to make a career out of
nice.
Being a musician? Yeah.
Nice.
So you turn the result of that story is you take every negative and turn it into a positive. To me, the negative was impersonating Jermaine Jackson. The positive was my uncles got to drink a lot when they were over there, you know what I'm saying? But the positive for me is to be able to, you know, find a way to turn the frequency and find my own voice in my own lane.
Love
by
that.
Listening to my elders and just following the paths, following the Indian trails. I just followed the old Indian trails.
Nice.
And that's how I got here.
Nice, mm-hmm. nice. So what's the next song that we're about to hear?
That's a good question.
Yeah, we're gonna play another song from the self-titled DMD. Which means Daru, Marcus, and Doug. It's not special about
it's not
it,
deep.
Like, something like very creative.
Put a lot of time into that.
5 seconds for D&D.
It's actually the first song, so.
What's the name of the song?
The Boom.
The Boom. The Boom.
Marcus named these songs, so.
I could have come up with no, you know. But real quick, like, the whole vibe of this project is really fun for all of us, but, mm-hmm. You guys know the meters? Anybody knows the meters?
Yeah. Yeah.
Think of that vibe. It's instrumental. Think of like Sissy Strut, but with a twist. Mm-hmm. So, you know, what Doug is bringing with the rock, the funk, I'm bringing little flavors to it. Daru's doing this thing. That's what DMD is, pretty much. So let's check it. Let's do it. One. We'll be right back.
we're gonna take a really quick break. Not even for 5 minutes. So stand by as we just go on a really quick break.
Sounds good to
me. I take that back.
Time for those fish sandwiches.
I guess. Take that back.
Yeah, I would love some water, man. Thank you.
We're just going to hand them water. We're not taking a break. Sorry about that.
It's holy water right here.
It's holy water.
This came straight from Reverend.
That was our break. And resume.
Sorry.
So Marcus, I've got to ask you this.
Yes.
What some people also don't know about Marcus is that Marcus has been featured in movies. He played in Rosewood, because, you know, I got to call it out, right? Right? You know, we still got to talk about it. So you still have your SAG card, right?
Yeah, I do. So I get $20 a month every time it gets played.
So can we expect a little bit more acting from you? Is that why you're here in Brooklyn?
Man, if everything, you know, opportunity brings itself, maybe I may act a little bit. I don't know, but I'm a musician. I feel more comfortable when I have the guitar right here. You know, this is what I do. So, I mean, as far as like movie scores, stuff like that, behind the scenes stuff, I would love to do music, you know, music scores and stuff. But acting, nah, I leave it for, you know, Idris Elba, those cats. Mm-hmm. You guys like those. Uh-huh. You know, you know. Yeah.
Okay. So, set us up for the next song that we're about to hear.
How much time we got? Seriously.
About 10 more minutes.
So do 10 more minutes?
We have 10 minutes, we're
going to
play. Oh,
okay. Because we actually have three more songs.
Yeah.
But do we need to cut back? Like
No.
Oh.
Okay.
No. Y'all want to hear another song from the album?
Yeah. You want to hear another song from the album? Is this okay?
You got to wait till the screen.
We're live. Live streams.
So you have two songs that you're going to play right now.
No, we're going to do one.
What's the name of the next record?
West Coast. Okay. Yo, I'm gonna be honest. I have to remember these songs because it's been a minute.
It's been a minute, and everything was like track one, track two.
Yeah.
And then I had to name the titles. So then when we was like doing the artwork, and the guy, we had a conference call, and guy was like, "Yeah, you know, the first single is going to be After Dark." I said, "What? What's After Dark? I don't know that song." And then I said, "Play it." And Uncle D played it. Oh, yeah. We know that one. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're all confused.
Yeah.
So we know them as track 1 through 10.
Yeah. We get used to the title.
So go ahead and go into it. Yeah.
The next one is track 3.
Maybe.
It's called West Coast.
Bonus. Okay. Bonus tracks. Okay.
Yeah.
So how do people keep in contact with DMD? Is there...
Call his manager.
Uncle G.
How do we...
So, yeah, that's a good question.
That's
a really good question.
Or individually. So, Daru, like, how do we get in contact? How do we know what's going on with you? When you guys doing next show?
Yeah, so you can catch me and check all my scheduling on Rusic Records. That's RUSICRECORDS.com. Yeah. You can find the schedule, you know, and everything is gonna be on there. Yeah.
Same here, officialmarcusmachado.com. All tour dates, same Uncle D.
Doug Wimbish, I can give you my bank account number.
No, that's right.
Donating this money to the next generation. DougWimbish.com, that's how you can reach me.
Perfect. Yeah. And you guys are all on social media as well, Instagram, Facebook.
Yeah, Daru Jones on Facebook, IG, same Daru Jones. Mm-hmm. And actually my team, well, one of my team members are here, Dan, raise your hand.
Perfect.
Dan.
Perfect. And same for you as well, official
Marcus Machado. Yep.
And what are you guys doing next as far as the album's concerned? Are you doing an album release party, or what can we expect next?
Actually, we're playing in Connecticut. We're premiering in Connecticut this Saturday at Sully's.
Sully's, yeah.
So we're going to play an official show this Saturday. And otherwise, we'll keep y'all posted. We're going to, like Marcus said, we're going to release the single After Dark on Friday.
After Dark on Friday.
And just stay tuned. We'll keep y'all posted. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Yeah. Okay, perfect. So set us up for the next song that we're about to hear, second and last song.
Any Jimi Hendrix fans?
Yes.
Let me swap out for that one.
Yeah. So, you know, that's my favorite guitar player of all time. So mm-hmm. we're going to do a song from Band of Gypsies, that area. It's a thing called Power of Soul.
Yeah, I just want to highlight. I know we're going next to the next song. This is a collaboration. So we're all three musicians coming together for one project. So you know, we all have our individual things that we do outside of this, but this is a collaboration. So the website and stuff like that will soon come. But for right now, you can just individually find information from each of our websites.
Perfect.
Yep.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah. Let's go into the song.
We'll be right back.
To an end. I want to thank you, Daru Jones, Marcus Machado, Doug Wimbush. Thank you so much for feeding our souls and coming together to present DMD. Please be sure to pick up the self-titled album DMD when it's released in spring of 2017. Don't forget to check in or stop by our Brick House Studios every Thursday to hear more of the best music Brooklyn has to offer. You can also check this out and past episodes anytime at youtube.com/BRICTV and podcast episodes at soundcloud.com/BRICRadio. So, DMD, give us a little something-something that we can rock out to after this.